This is a simple video on how to set up your Midland Mobile MXT100 for the channels. To set the channels, you see your menu button here, your up and down buttons here. We're going to basically scan back and forth here and say hit the menu button, and it all takes place very quickly. So as I go through this, you're going to see me move quite quickly, but when the screen stops flashing, it then exits out of the menu pretty quickly. And there's a certain convenience to that, and there's also a certain kind of challenge to it, because if you have to think too long, it's gone. So, and if you don't press the menu button to engage, to remember it, it'll exit out and it won't remember the channel selection you've made. So we use channels up and down. We've got an up and down selector here, so we're, you know, basically 7 to 21 here. Well, that's kind of interesting that there's somebody on that channel. So, anyway, somebody talking about CB channel, so that was kind of funny. So we're gonna use 20 because our club uses 20-20. So 20 on the main channel, 20 on the sub channel. So in order to get the sub channel programmed in, I'm going to press the menu button. It's going to show an F1 right here. I'm going to immediately press the menu button again, and it's going to give me the chance to change my numbers up and down. So press this, F1, press it again. Now I've got my up and down. Now as long as I'm moving one of these up or down, I can change these, okay? So I'm just going to go to 2015, and I'm going to press memory again. So when I press the menu button again, okay, it allowed it to remember it. So when I press this one more time, and I press it again, there's my 15 sub-channel. Now, if I change this, right again, and if I change this to, say, 12, okay, if I let it exit out, which it'll do right now, what I find out is that it didn't save that 12 for sub-channel. Even though I changed it, it didn't save it unless I went back and hit the menu again. So 1, 2, see, still 15. So I'm going to go back up to 20. That's actually what I really want. Press the menu button again, and it's saved. So the other channel that I use is 721. So I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to go just use this down selector, and I'm going to say 7, again, 21. There it is. And I know it's there, so I canceled it out. And let's say that if I wanted to change that to 712, okay? So again, go back to 12. Again, press the menu button. That's what remembers it. So when I press it again, there's my 712. I'm going to go up to 21. And remember it. That's it. That's how easy it is to program. The other thing you need to understand is that if you want to use this and scan these channels, it's very easy to make the unit scan these channels. When you go up and down, you'll see that there's no little circle there, okay? That little circle is the scanning operation, okay? So when I say I want to scan, when I press that scan button, it's going back and forth, you'll see, between 20 and 7, okay? I can scan as many channels as I want to. If I wanted to scan a whole bunch of them, I could. But right now, I only have it set on that. So if I press that again, and I say I want to go up and down, if I wanted to change this, and I wanted to start scanning channel 6, I could press that and hold it. And you see the circle appears here. If I want to get rid of that, press it and let it go. So now remember, if you press it short burst, it goes and scans. Press it again. Press it and hold it. Makes it remember to scan that. Now, I'm going to turn the scan off for that, because the only channels I want to scan is 721. I've got my S here, which is letting me know that I'm on CTSC mode. And when you say, how do I know whether I'm in CTSC mode or not, okay? With the Midland radios, one of the key things to realize is that if you're trying to communicate with people in FRS, unless you're communicating with Midland-only radios, what you have to understand is that there's an F2 function. The F2 function, when we go here and press this again, what you'll see is we press this and press this again, what you'll see is that off, okay? If I have that off and I say I want that off or on, okay? I don't want that on. I want that off, because that is the channel that only allows it to communicate with other Midland radios. So if you have a problem with your friends not hearing you, but you hearing your friends just fine, that's what's going on. So you have to go to the F2 function to realize. So back to the F2 again, press it again, it's off. We want that off. We do not want that on. If I want to simply change my squelch options, okay, I can press this. It goes into my F3 mode, okay? Press the F3 again. This is my squelch setting, okay? So if I don't want any squelch at all, I can set it down really low, and I'll get lots of static. If I want it set up, say, mid-range, I can press that. Once I press it, then it remembers it. So again, F3, press it again, and it's set on 5. Press it again, and we're exiting. There's tons of control with this radio, and one of the easy little things to do that makes it really nice is you can set it up where when you hit a button, it makes a noise, so you know whether you're hitting the buttons or not. If you want to change that, you can press and get to the F4 setting. Again, scrolling up and down to get to the F4 setting. There is our entry into that. If we want to change this, we can cut this down so it's not so loud. Basically has a couple different levels. 60 is basically zero, okay? B is B0, okay? And basically what it's going back to it again, back in B1, 2, 3, and I said 60 earlier, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and back to 1. 0, I think that's plenty loud enough back there. Once we've set it, then we know we'll confirm back to that. Last thing, transmit power. Transmit power, F5, okay? Go to the transmit power. There we go again. High or low? High or low? If I go to low and lock it in, there it is. Press it again, and we're back to low. If I want to go to high, press high. Remember, there's my F. There we're on high. So we're good to go. Other than that, your button over here, squelch on, squelch off. And your button here is going to basically turn the light on. So if you want to turn the light on, it's kind of a little tricky. These buttons do a lot of different things. But what you find out is that all you have to do to turn the light on is just hit that button, turn it off. Press it and hold it a little bit, and that turns it off. And so what you're seeing here, kind of funny enough, I'm learning this as a go here. A little bit brighter, a little bit brighter. Dim. So each time you hit that button momentarily, it gets a little bit brighter. So if you've got a real, you know, need for a real bright display, nighttime, you won't want the thing blinding you. Daytime, you want it bright. So no doubt. You want to turn it on, turn it off, press and hold. That's it. One last note, the microphone, is my understanding, it does remove. What I have understood is that it's not that easy to get back in. So, as a safe bet, don't take it out. So, hope this helps you program your radio. My installation is in a 2011 Mini Cooper. I have built a platform underneath inside of the console. The platform is a simple wedge block of wood with a mounting. These mounts are really nice because they allow us to go in and basically pull a couple of clips and pop the thing out. The way this is mounted is there's actually a rubber shelf in here, and it's actually very easy to remove. Once I pull the radio out, which requires more hands than I have right now, but basically pushing this clip aside, pushing this clip aside, and pulling the thing out makes it very easy to remove. This shelf will pop up and pull out. I have it at about a 40 degree angle sitting in here. And I hope this helps you with your installation and understanding of the unit.